Hello, what's up guys? Welcome back into Push My Trick episode 2. And this time we're gonna work on the front roll trick, all the variation, front roll slide. I'm gonna show you in the next minutes what kind of trick we can do and how to improve your style, okay? I remind you, this series is only for advanced riders, so you want to make sure you know how to land the front roll perfectly, 5-on-5, good style, good kite control, okay? If we want to go on into the next step. So trick number one, double front roll inverted. You want to go big, that's a nice trick, it's really stylish. You need some good wind to do that. So jump and go in your first rotation directly inverted, okay? You jump at the top, try to bring your legs up into your rotation, and then on the way down you want to do a normal horizontal rotation just at the end. So there's another variation of the double front roll. It's the double front roll with a grab on the middle. And this time you're not gonna jump with your kite much, you're just gonna keep it at 1 o'clock. I want a really strong pop, okay? And you're going to your first rotation, immediately you're gonna try to grab the middle of your boat, okay? And doing it again in inverted rotation. This time you do the inverted on the second rotation. The front row spin, okay? I'm gonna use little gems here from Metallica to show you what kind of rotation I'm gonna do. So you want to go high and to do a front row rotation, start with 1, 2, just to feel the feeling of this rotation. It's really special. You want to stay completely straight. You want to rotate in the same axis, okay? You want to rotate in this kind of axis completely, okay? You don't want to go inverted, you don't want to go on the side, just straight. For that, you only want to be compact as much as possible. If you have a compact body, the rotation is going to be even more smooth. So what I'm doing, checking the video, I'm putting my deep over line in the middle, okay? And as soon as I'm starting, I want to wrap my body in to stay compact. So I'm going to wrap my head also inside, wrap my hand, grab my back, and I'm going to start rotating with my head on this side so I can do as much rotation I want. You're going to try to feel in the air. At one moment, the speed of your rotation is going to increase. After the first two rotations, the speed is going to increase. So try to understand at which moment you need to start the rotation to land nicely, okay? It's really nice. My best, it's 8 rotation, okay? So I challenge you, if you can do more than 8 with a spin, send me the video, okay? I remind you, the tricks I'm saying right now doesn't have to be in the order I'm saying you. It's just different variation of the front roll. You can try each one of them at a different moment, okay? The low front roll hand slide, really stylish, don't need much wind to do that, but you want some big kite, I would say 12 or 13 at least, to get some good lift, okay, some good hang time close to the one. We want to stay low, okay, so it's gonna work better with a big kite. So the key of this trick is that you have to do something really unusual. You're gonna want to fall forward, like you're gonna crash, okay? Pop hard, kite at 10 o'clock, and try to reach the water with your hand, but by doing that, you're gonna slowly go in the front, slowly you're gonna want to hand drag yourself, and bring your legs in top and start to loop it, okay, and land nicely, okay? So you want to do a loop at the end also, really useful. That's how you're gonna get out. Kite 10, 11, 12, then at 12 give a good kick, 12, 1 o'clock, and loop your kite. So you have the timing, is really important on this trip. Here's one more tip for you. You want to start to do a lot of grabs, okay? Into your rotation, it looks really stylish. It shows a lot of control from the rider, okay? You go into your rotation, just don't do a touch. Keep it grabbed during the whole rotation and try to understand which leg I'm gonna stretch, which leg I'm gonna bend. There's so much space around your boat, okay? You can go for a nose grab, tail grab, between your legs, melon, indie, and Even I'm grabbing with two hands sometimes. This looks nice also. The next trick is the front roll build up. One of my favorite trick. You go big, and there are so many ways to do it again. You can grab the handle, can grab the rail. That's one of my favorites to grab the tail, okay? You go in. The trick is to kind of put your front foot first into the strap, not the back one, okay? When you finish your rotation, you want to start to put the front. So example, if I do it on the right, I'm gonna put my right foot first, okay, into the strap, then the second foot, and land nicely, okay? Again, this requests a lot of kite control, a lot of good pressure, and can be done also with a flip, okay? That's really nice also. Just flip it, grab your handle, put it back in your foot, and double flip. There's no limits, okay? Stop the lagging, worry about them brothers lagging on you. They're sliding on you, bump and grind every night upon you, getting slag upon you. So that's the end. We have some bonus trick for you, and check them. I just want to inspire you guys to give you some ideas for the next time you go riding. It's always cool to try new things, okay? Don't get stuck at your level. Every time, even after 11 years of kiting, every time I'm going out, I'm gonna try something new, okay? And that's how you progress. That's the only way. Remember, keep it stylish, and give me a like if you enjoyed this video, and write me a comment, please, so I can know what can improve for the next time, okay? It's always something to speak to a camera, not used to. And have fun, enjoy, and stay safe. You don't know what I'm looking for. You don't know what I'm looking for. Check, look. I know this shit sounds philosophical and borderline ironic, but this topic's very logical. Whether it's a blessing or a motherfucking obstacle that breaks apart and leaves the brokenhearted to the hospital. Powerful devotion for some. When I was young, lack of any kind of emotion had me hopeless and numb. Back when I was dumb, I was never running my gums, just always running from webs that I spun. Stress weighing a ton, weight was more than I was able to bear. Cause in my mind it's mad fruity to be labelled a pear, but blatantly scared, escaping any fragrant affair. That was my duty, always threw me into time to despair. Writing rhymes to try to describe the many times that I cared. Cause honestly, to put it properly, I'm underprepared. And who am I to play the cast away? I've got a bigger part to play. So when they ask me, it ain't hard to say. You don't know what I'm looking for.